Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Mutant and Monster Mayhem was made in 2005 by WayForward Technologies and was released by Tech2Go. It is a plug-and-play gaming device. Sadly, the gun lacks sights. The handle is rather short and not suited for being used by a huge adult hand. The trigger is hard and has sharp edges. Prolonged play was quite painful to the whole hand and especially to the trigger finger. The gun sports a reset button and an on-off switch. The battery compartment should include a battery caddy for 4 AA cells. Sadly, my gun came without this. Using a laboratory power supply unit, I found out that the gun expects 6 volts DC, with the plus pole being left when the gun points to the TV. Building an own caddy is difficult as the compartment is small. Finally, I ended up soldering wires of a PSU directly onto the springs, which were just barely wettable with solder. The gun is notable for featuring 3 distinct RCA connectors, which is rarely seen on plug-and-play devices. Nevertheless, the system gives out audio in mono. Mutant and Monster Mayhem is not the first TMNT light gun game. 1988, Bandai released another game for the Takara Video Challenger, which was based on the 1987 TV series. Mutant and Monster Mayhem, however, is based on the newer 2003 series. I am just familiar with the original comics by Laird and Eastman and with the 80s series. Therefore, I can't say how faithful the game is to its origin. The game consists of 4 chapters made of 3 levels each, which are concluded in a boss fight. Chapters can be chosen in any order. One chapter takes place on a Triceraton spaceship. This chapter reminds me of Body Count, which I reviewed in episode 26. Another chapter takes the player to Mutant City. Toonie Forest is another chapter. Finally, there is the ninja-themed Battle Nexus. Each chapter has a unique set of enemies. At the conclusion of a level, a score screen is displayed. Beating a chapter will show a brief animation. Succeeding all chapters will trigger the credits roll. The player has a certain number of lives, which are used up if the health gauge is exhausted. The lives are restocked at the beginning of every level. The total number of lives is altered by the difficulty setting. Easy will give the player 5 lives, whereas hard mode will provide 2 lives. If the player runs out of lives, the game is over and doesn't provide any continues. From time to time, a fellow turtle appears on the screen. Shooting him will cause the player to lose a whole life and a score penalty is triggered. As a default weapon, the player uses a semi-automatic gun with infinite ammunition and unlimited capacity. Items such as health, screen-clearing bombs, and a shield and 2 other weapons can be picked up. The other weapons are a spread gun and a full automatic gun. Personally, I think the game could have been much better with some little changes. Nevertheless, I am glad I own the system despite its flaws. I like the art style and the music. The ordinary gameplay felt much too easy compared to the boss fights. Furthermore, I find it lazy that the difficulty setting just alters the number of lives. I think the box looks really appealing. It allows the customer to touch and feel the gun. My acknowledgement goes to Daniel Waker Hauser of TMNTToys.com for letting me use his photos. A link to his lovely website can be found in the video description. This is the end of the review. My name is Ben. I thank you for viewing.